Freedom Trail is a location in Boston, Massachusetts, that has many places that were vital during the time of the Revolution. It is important because it gives people a first-hand look at some of the Revolutionary War's influences, historical sites, and events. Some of these places include the Old North Church, the Park Street Church, the Old South Meeting House, and so on.
Another fun fact about Freedom Trail was that it was established in 1958 and is 4 kilometers long.
We all know that the Old South Meeting House is a museum today, but what's the history of it? During the time of the Revolution, columnist meetings were held in there and they discussed big issues. Ben Franklin was baptized there. Phyllis Wheatley, the first published black poet, was a member there. However, the most significant event that the Old South Meeting House was a part of was the Boston Tea Party.
The king was taxing the colonists on all tea, leaving them with only one company that sold cheap tea, the British East India Company. This was just another sneaky way of King George to get more money from the colonists, leaving them poor and him rich. The colonists were baffled, but the king did not care. More than 5,000 colonists met in the Old South Meeting House to figure out how to resolve this problem.
When all hope seemed lost, Sam Adams gave a secret cue that signaled about 50 men dressed as Mohawk Indians to aboard the tea ships and dump about 90,000 pounds of tea into the ocean. This protest is now a very famous event in American history. Today, inside the Old South Meeting House, you can see John Hancock's portable writing desk, a statue of Phyllis Wheatley, tea leaves and tea rate labels from the Boston Tea Party, and so much more.
You should visit Freedom Trail because it teaches you about America's history. If you do visit Freedom Trail, I recommend seeing the Old South Meeting House. It will remind you of one of America's most effective protests that avoided violence but showed our strength.